yeah, y'all know me. You know like I know. Yeah, y'all know me. I done been alone since I've been me. Then we turn friends to a family. Tell me why it feels like we enemies now. Everybody getting hard feelings. Everybody wanna tell secrets. Somebody should've told me. Need to take three. See, I grew up stealing in Pittsburgh. Mama died young, so I been learned. I remember when they came and got my sister. I told them I would kill just to get her. I really kept my word. I got Simone back. Pulled up to the A, got a life on track.
How you let me
take your mind off that?
Yeah, that's about here, Laverne's door.
I remember I was down for you, bitches.
Anyway, out here, waiting for a pickup.
I remember I was there for you, bitches.
Alright, back at y'all, yeah. Just wanted to touch bases with you right quick. I hope it's clear enough for y'all. Anyway, you know, I get phone calls, texts, whatever. Yo, Nate, yo, gangster. How them flatbed rates looking? You know, I'm thinking about coming over. You know, that's what you want to do, do it. But I'm telling y'all, don't think the grass is green on the other side. Because I done been in some areas, I done seen some box rates paying better than what some rates I'm getting, you know. And believe me, I'm not exaggerating. I've seen it. This, I can honestly say, I'm only talking from my experience. This is something you do because you like to do it. I came out here to do it. Honestly, to lose some weight and get this exercise. Because I told y'all, this is my second career, you know. I did 20 years doing something totally different, you know. And the last 8 of them, I was running my own little business. I don't know how that is for y'all. Maybe I can set it down here. Yeah, I still got the old belly. Y'all see the belly. But anyway, and of course, you know, jumping in that truck, you're going to swell up quick. Gonna swell up quick, and I had started gaining weight, so I said, you know what, let me do something different, see how that worked for y'all. Yeah, I'm just putting the straps on. You can see I got chains running down. I'm just putting straps on for extra security, so DOT don't have to say nothing, you know, because they always want to put their 2 cents in. Plus I'd rather have it over secure than under secure. But anyway, you know, like I said, y'all will be highly upset. Y'all coming over here thinking, okay, them open deck boys making all the money. Right now, the market is kind of bad across the board, fella. Like I said, I done been in some area wishing I had a box to get that dog on load, something I could bump the dock and go. You know, hold on 1 second, hold that thought, be right back. All right, I put some music in that little spot, and maybe I edited it out. But anyway, the point I'm trying to get at is, race bad all across the board, and you're gonna get less runs than you do at box. I'm talking from my experience. Can't speak with nobody else. If I got delivery 8 o'clock in the morning, even if I'd have slept through the shipper, which y'all know I like to do, once the shipper get in, I still got to unstrap, unchain, put all that stuff up, deadhead somewhere. I told y'all doing this, you're likely to have a father deadhead. Deadhead somewhere else. Go there, get loaded. See if we can switch that around. Go ahead, get loaded, strap all that crap down. And by that time, my clock probably pretty much burnt out. when y'all could have went and bumped another dot, got in that extra run, you know. Whoever, I could have bumped the dot and got the extra run in, you know. But now, pretty much, I done killed today, you know. And, you know, everything ain't pieces of cream. Just think about, if you end up coming over here, which I'm not here, I'm just telling you my experience, you'd be highly upset. You got to sit there, spend an hour chaining something down, tying it down, then spend another hour and a half, 2 hours tarping it. Look at this, not a top load. And pretty much getting the same race y'all getting out there. You know, is it a little bit better? Yeah. Is it good? Nah, not really. Like I said, I done been in some air, wishing I had a doggone box. Wishing I had a box. But I had a reason for coming over here. I had to get out that doggone truck and start moving around a little bit. Your boy Gangster was getting too big. You know. Plus the health thing of it, you know, high blood pressure, diabetes, y'all know the routine. I ain't got to go through it. I ain't got it. I ain't speaking it on me, but, you know, that stuff that run prevalent in the trucker community, you know. So getting out here doing this little extra work don't bother me at all. Hell, I told y'all, I did telephone and computer wire for 20-some-odd years, built computer rooms, so I ain't no stranger to work at all. And I'm not saying all this to discourage y'all. What I am saying, be ready. If you decide to do it, be ready. And really think about it, because, hell, I think mine was a cheap investment. I found some stuff on Craigslist, like I told y'all. Spot by the grand on that. And those two tops done ripped up already. Y'all done heard the story, you seen my other videos. Let me give a couple shout out to Show. Y'all go check out Show channel. Shout out to RLC TV. He got some stuff going on. Kids giveaway for the summer in a couple of communities that touch me real close. Matter of fact, I'm trying to get involved in the one he having in Austell, Georgia. And he doing one down in, I think, Overtown in Miami. So, you know, both of them areas touched me pretty good. Yeah. So shout out to them. And, yeah, so, like I said, I had a purpose for trying to get out here. That camera dirty. I had a purpose for trying to get my big butt out here. You know. Like I said, don't think the grass is green on the other side, because it ain't. It ain't. You know, sometimes I be saying to myself, whew, you want me to strap it? You want me to top it? And then you want me to turn around and I got 300 miles that day and 400 the next day to get there? Okay. But it's all good, you know. Did I accomplish my goal? Yeah. I can tell y'all, only been, what, two? I done been out here 2.5, 3 months now. I done lost 2 pant sizes. Yeah. Hey, it ain't even summer good yet. It ain't started getting hot around this thing yet, y'all. Yeah. But that's my little rant and rave on the subject. You know, if it's something you really want to do, really want to learn, up your game, do your thing. But just to do it, just to say, I'm going to chase us. Them boys making money over there, you know, don't be fooled. Then, you know, you got the learning curve on it. You know, y'all done seen me with the struggle. You know, if y'all say anything about Gangster, I try to keep it real with y'all 100, yo. Y'all see me go through some things out here. First, you got to learn the lane, realize there's different dead areas now compared to before. You know, got to get your rank up with new brokers now, new agents. You know, so it's a starting process. So, you know, don't think you're going to get out here, switch over, and learn it from scratch. Because believe me, I blow up Show You Right phone, I blow up L Boogie phone, and I blow up Mr. Lee's. And it's another phone I blow up, Joe. I don't know if you watch my channel or not, but I was talking to Joe about open deck before I even came to Land Star. Matter of fact, he wanted me to come to Land Star with teams and run with him, but it just never worked out. Sorry about that bad camera angle, y'all. I apologize. You boy gangster trying to get some work in. So I called him up too. You know, to get advice. You know, sometimes he hit me up, check up on me, you know, to get advice. Cause it's a whole different animal messing with this, y'all. I'll try to get y'all outright look at everything I got going on out here. Yeah, that's old Becky. Anyway, I'm out here south of Nashville, Laverne. Strapping this load down. It ain't due till Monday up in Ohio. And to tell you the truth, I'll probably leave out 3 o'clock in the morning. I'm south of Nashville, so I'm gonna go hang out with the wife on Mother's Day. You know how that go. Get up early, get that load done. Then I got another load waiting on me. Actually, a better paying load than this one. And they come. Remember, I used to talk about them unicorn load. I got a short unicorn load. Hopefully it's gonna be paying close to $4 a mile, but it ain't going number 480 something miles. So do the math. And then, but it's taking me into a dead area. At least what I perceive to be a dead area. Yeah, I got my little box on here. Keep some of the straps in. You know, I do got the headache rack on now, but sorry about that. We got my headache rack on now, but like I said before, you still have so much shit. Gotta have somewhere to put it. I need to get me another box. I just got this little cheap box real quick before I got my headache right, thinking this would be enough to hold my stuff. You know, the headache rack and everything to hold my stuff, but still ain't work out still. As a matter of fact, I still got 2 sets of chains sitting in the truck. I got slots for it, just ain't bought them out yet. Save them. All right, y'all, I'll probably do one more clip to this, upload it. It's your boy Gangsta. Holla back. Alright, let me hello. You got to say some things. back to the equipment, you know, if you think about switching over. Like I say, you know, I spent about $1,000, got stuff out crazy list, then turn around, probably spent about another $600. So my total thing was $1,600. And just imagine buying all that stuff and then come to find out you don't like it. That's how I get it. That's how you see deals on Craigslist all the time and El Cap. Cats not thinking about it. You know, they just going, getting $2,500 worth of equipment and then realizing they can bit off more than they can chew. So really think about it. Shout out to Trucker Rail. Y'all check out his channel. Yeah, what else I forgot? I forgot a couple of things, you know. You know, like I said, grass ain't greener on the other side. It'll look construction area. Y'all know how that goes. Grass ain't always green on the other side. Just like when I was doing telephone and computers, I stayed in there for 20 years plus. Because that was an industry, if you had to love it. If you didn't love it, you didn't do it. You know what I'm saying? You weren't cut out for that type of work. You know, yeah, you got some time. You cushy, soft shoes, khaki pants, nice little polo shirt. You know, doing the business meetings, you know, letting them know how the install gonna go. Now this other day, you straight up blue jeans, gloves, you know, pulling in 1,500-pound cables. For people don't know, 1,500-pound cables, that big telephone line you see this thick, you know. So imagine humping that out. So saying all that said, you know, with me, I ain't no stranger to work.
get over here, you gonna work, baby. You gonna work. You know. Yeah, you good days and bad days. Y'all done seen it. Y'all done seen it. Y'all know about it, about it. You know, gangsta don't be whining, gangsta be venting. Straight up venting. Got to. Like I tell y'all, hey, y'all be watching my therapy. All right, I ain't gonna make this video too long. Put another couple of clips on it. Keep it moving. All right.
Hi, you too. Yeah, today Mother's Day, so, you know, I had to, you know, get it together a little bit today. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Still ain't got the haircut, but that's going to be next week. Got some things going on. But yeah, at this Ryan and Swish, some kind of wine tasting place the wife wanted to do, you know, for Mother's Day. But back to the subject of the video. This video, playing with a little software, so if everything ain't perfect, don't blame it, you know. And another thing, like I'm saying, it wasn't to discourage anybody to want to come over to doing the open deck. Just know what you're getting into, you know, especially in today's market. I went over that a little bit with y'all, you know, on the video, just to let y'all know, hey, you know, you get ready out here, some equipment, you got to make an investment. And once you make that investment, you got to go through your little learning curve, you know, learning what brokers and agents to deal with, the areas, like I was saying, as well as you're just in a different ballpark. It's totally different. Yeah, but I ain't gonna talk too long. I got to get in here and get a couple bottles of wine up in me. You know what I'm saying? You know, hey, your boy gangsta more than one dimensional. You know what I mean? It's best to broaden your horizon, try everything. You know, get a little wine, a little cheese, a little whatever, whatever, whatever. You know what I'm saying? All right, y'all. Once again, it's your boy gangsta. Peace. I'm out, y'all. Holler at me. You see me. Yo.